is it important for Ghanaian main companies to manufacture this fabric because they know the history behind it, because they're part of the culture versus Dutch wax, Brazil, or Chinese people who are manufacturing the
fabric? Yeah, so like a number of the ones that are produced in Ghana by the Ghanaian like producers and the African producers in the land make different meanings compared to the ones that come in. One is you can go and like customize the fabric. So when you're going to customize the fabric, yeah, you can take your design, go there to customize it either for a school logo or a celebration of your grandma's birthday or anything. They can reproduce it for you. But the motifs that would surround this image wouldn't be just any image.
It wouldn't be a shoe.
It would be an image that is going to add meaning to the picture. You see? So it wouldn't just be a bag or it wouldn't just be a shoe. It's two things you have to be mindful here. It's either the color or the design.
Okay.
So if it's very bright color, you can use it for any ceremony that is joyous, for a ceremony. Ceremony of life, ceremony of maybe marriage, outdooring. But in the Muslim community, like in Nima where I grew up, when they call it farinzani, when they wear farinzani on a weekend, when you see a group of women wearing farinzani, which is the white cloth, black and white, or blue and white, it means they are going to a naming ceremony. But when a person died in that neighborhood, they don't wear, they don't have an attire for funeral. We wear different ones for funeral. But in another community, they would wear either black, white, black, or black and white, or black and red, or red with like touch of black in it, like dominating color would be red. So all of this would add like meanings and all of that. But if you just throw anything on the fabric, it means you're just making your money.